Perched high above the city of Athens, the ancient temples of the Acropolis, including the majestic Parthenon, are an engineering mystery. They stand in one of the most seismically active countries in the world. Recent earthquakes have demolished modern buildings in the city. So how have these ancient temples survived for over 2,000 years? Seismologist Yannis Kalogeris monitors seismic activity on the Acropolis.
This is a typical installation site of the accelerographic array of the Acropolis. Here you can see the accelerograph.
This accelerograph, one of 10 positioned across the site, measures how much the ground shakes.
We are now connected to 5 instruments.
When he looks back at the data, Yannis discovers that during earthquakes, something strange happens here at the Parthenon.
This is a typical record of a small earthquake, a local earthquake.
The recording shows that the foundations of the Parthenon shake less than the ground in the surrounding city. But why is this happening? What is special about this place?
The difference is because of the local characteristics, by the geology of the site.
The rock itself is solid, but the city around it is built on loose soil that vibrates strongly in an earthquake.
The Parthenon is built on limestone. It's more stiff, more rigid.
It appears that the Parthenon's foundations, built directly on solid rock, have helped it survive. But this alone doesn't explain how these temples have stood firm against earthquakes. The biggest clue to what makes these structures so special hides inside their stones. Blow the Parthenon apart, and you won't find an ounce of mortar to bond the marble together. Instead, there are mysterious slots in the blocks, and inside them, iron clamps. In between the column drums, there are wooden wedges and pins. These pieces of iron and wood help protect the temple from earthquakes. But how do they do it? Civil engineer Zanis Kanteas works with the restoration team. He thinks the ancient Greeks did something clever when they installed these connecting pieces.
The clamps were placed in sockets that were carefully carved on the top side of the blocks.
He's noticed that ancient builders deliberately cut the holes larger than the clamps.
The gap between the clamp and the socket was covered with lead, which was melted and poured inside the socket. You can still see here part of the lead saved.
The lead seals the iron clamps from the air and stops them from rusting. But it also plays a critical role in an earthquake.
Lead, since it is a much softer material, would absorb part of the stresses.
During an earthquake, the soft, flexible lead allows the marble blocks to move while the clamps stop the walls from falling down.
Of course, it worked very well. The lifetime of the monument is a great proof of it.
The system that protects the columns is even smarter. When they pulled the columns apart, archaeologists found pieces of wood 2,400 years old and amazingly well preserved. The segments are called empolia and polos.
Column drums were connected to each other by a set of 3 wooden components, 2 empolia and 1 polos. The polos would be placed inside the hole of the 2 empolia, and this would be the connection of the drums.
The way the wood pieces work is ingenious. Without them, a big quake could shake the columns out of alignment until they collapse. But the Empolia prevent this. They sit right in the middle of the drums and act like soft wooden joints. Their special shape lets columns wobble in a quake, but always keeps the drums in line. That means they don't collapse. So when the earth stops shaking, the Parthenon lives to see another day. Archaeologists even have found proof the concept works.
We're lucky enough to have an example of how a lateral displacement between two drums has a result in the shape of the pollux. The pollux, who was sheared, has stayed in this condition and preserved extremely well.
The wood held the stones.